We want to use f of x, which is given here as a list of ordered pairs, to answer the following questions. Our first two questions are evaluate f of 8 and then determine x when f of x equals 8. Once again, notice how f of x is a list of ordered pairs, and therefore we can call f of x a discrete function. When working with functions, it's often helpful to think of f of the input equals the output. So if we have a function of x as we have here, we can say f of x equals y, and therefore x will be the input and y will be the output. So for each ordered pair, we can think of the input comma the output. So to evaluate f of 8, 8 is the input or x value. So we'll look through these ordered pairs and look for an x coordinate of 8, which is here. Notice how when the input or x value is 8, the output or y value is 36. And therefore, f of 8 equals 36. Next, we're asked to determine x when f of x equals 8. Well, because we're given the function value, 8 is the y value, so now we're looking for an ordered pair in f where the y coordinate is 8. Notice here it is. So when the function value or y value is 8, notice how the x value or input must be 12. So here x equals 12 when f of x equals 8. Let's take a look at two more examples. Using the same function f of x, we want to evaluate f of 0. Again, notice how 0 is the input or the x value. So looking at the ordered pairs, we're looking for an x coordinate of 0, which is here. So when the input is 0 or x is 0, the y coordinate or the output of the function or the function value is positive 12. Therefore, f of 0 equals 12. And now for the last question, we want to determine x when f of x equals 0. So again, here we're given the function value, which should be the y value. So now we're looking for a y coordinate of 0, not an x coordinate of 0. So going back to the ordered pairs, here is a point where the y coordinate or function value is 0, and therefore x, or the input, would have to be 4. So our answer is x equals 4. So the most important thing to remember is that when we're given the input, we're given the x value, and we're finding the function value or y value. And when we're given the function value, we're actually given the y value, and we're finding the x value. I hope you found this helpful.